The Honourable Member for Fort Rouge.
Amiigwech, Madam Speaker. Last night, the member for Fort Garry Riverview, the member for Wolseley, and myself attended the federal government's climate change town hall here in Winnipeg. The room was packed. There were some 300 people there, including plus an additional 75 who stayed in the hallway to participate. Groups such as the Manitoba Energy Justice Coalition, as well as many local residents' associations, had a strong presence. Indigenous people made their voices heard as well. I saw my friend from the Manitoba Métis Federation, President David Chartrand, as well as Chief of the Broken Head Ojibwe Nation, Jim Baer, there, as well as activists like Sadie Phoenix Lavoie and many others. Many non-Indigenous people present at the meeting last night were saying, listen to the words of Indigenous elders. People urged the federal government to invest in flood protection, to restore wetlands to act as carbon sinks, to consider the emissions and spill impacts of proposed pipelines, and much more. A call to say no to the Trans-Pacific Partnership was greeted with hearty applause. People argued the TPP would limit our ability to regulate fossil fuel and to invest in green technology. Our caucus agrees that the current iteration of the TPP is a bad deal for Canada. Of interest to this government was that many last night advocated for a carbon pricing plan. They agreed that the goal should be to provide a disincentive to the use of fossil fuels and that such a plan should be transparent. All revenues should go to subsidizing green technology and green jobs. The last word from the floor was a call to politicians to be brave. Brave enough to make the changes needed to protect our planet and our people. The first step to accomplishing that is to listen. It appears as though the federal government is listening, the NDP is listening, and I hope the members on the government side are listening as well. After all, our grandchildren will judge us based on how well we respond to the challenge of climate change.